Hey there, everyone. Welcome back to another week of astrology. I'm going to be reporting on the week of June 17 through June 23 of 2020. I kind of have a small window of opportunity to record this before the monsoon storms kind of kick in. They're all around me right now. Could get pretty crazy out there. So the aspects that we have this week, we have Mercury stationing retrograde in Cancer tomorrow, June 17. We have Mars sextile Pluto. The Sun is going to align with the North Node, so it's a very karmic week. Destiny is unfolding, which leads us into June 20th, where we have Mars sextile Jupiter, and then we have the solstice as the Sun enters Cancer, so a change of season. And that leads us also to the solar eclipse in Cancer. Very, very powerful, very, very strong. June 20th, really late at night on the West Coast, and that will be early morning, June 21st, in other places around the world. We also have the Sun, quincunx Saturn, in conjunct, an aspect of irritation adjustment to everything that Saturn rules. Talk about that. We also have Neptune slowing down and stationing retrograde by next week, June 22nd. Those are the main aspects, and then of course the lunar aspects, as always, day by day. Let's get started on this. So today, well, actually I'm starting June 17th, Wednesday, first thing in the morning. The moon is at 10 degrees of Taurus. So the moon is waning, releasing its energy for the next couple days through Taurus and through Gemini. And then it becomes new, eclipsed in Cancer, and builds through Cancer and Leo for the remainder of the week. Now, first thing, Wednesday morning, late Tuesday into Wednesday morning, June 17th, the moon is with Uranus. So it can create some level of instability or some disruptions. It's pretty early in the morning, so maybe there could be disruptions with sleep, things like that. But the moon is exalted in Taurus. And it is about, we're still continuing with, you know, material comforts and things that feel good to the five senses. These are major things. But we're also kind of emotionally having a connection to finances and material life. And that's ruled by Venus, which is still going through this retrograde process. So we're still evaluating. So this moon through Taurus is helping us get in touch with things that we want, things that we desire, things that we value, you know, understanding what's most important for us in this phase of our life. And we still don't have all the clarity we need to understand those things fully until Venus is completely done with its retrograde and its shadow phase by the end of July into the first week of August. But this is important, you know, with the moon in Taurus to understand what we want. It's also passing Uranus, so it's giving us the ability to look at things differently. Look at our material world, the earth, you know, what we value, and think about things that we maybe have never thought about before, being open to trying new things that could work out better than they would in previous times. So here's Mercury in Cancer stationing retrograde. It's slowing down. Officially, it stations retrograde really late on Wednesday. So let's move this forward by the hour. And the moon is continuing to move through Taurus all day on Wednesday. The moon does make a nice sextile to Cancer, Mercury in Cancer, for a few hours. First thing in the morning on Wednesday, it's a great time for communication. It's an opportunity to get your feelings across, to be understood better, to communicate, run errands, do something around material things, communications, emails, networking, any kind of message you have to get out there. There's a great window of opportunity to do that on Wednesday morning. I'm going to have to refer to my list here just to make sure I don't skip anything. Yeah, so the main aspects tomorrow, Wednesday, moon sextile Mercury. Moon will sextile Neptune later that night as Mercury is stationing retrograde. So it's mainly all about Moon and Taurus releasing, though, too. Releasing past attachments to things, material things that are no longer needed for us. Getting in touch with maybe, you know, understanding our material needs and what we want on a new level, looking at things differently, and then being willing to maybe say, okay, that no longer fits me. That's no longer what I want at this part of my life. And you can, you know, go through this Venus retrograde process that will continue and reflect on these things. As the day goes on, it's kind of this in-between day. It's not a bad day, actually. The moon is making positive aspects all day long, and the moon is exalted in Taurus. It should be a decent day. Now, we are in eclipse season, so we're already feeling the solar eclipse that's building up, which is going to amplify emotional energy. So there's still a lot of intense energy out there, don't get me wrong, but the moon is decent and happy tomorrow on Wednesday. So circumstances, the mood, generally speaking, is pretty calm. Now, it's still in the sign of Uranus, so there's always a possibility of disruptions when the moon is next to Uranus like this. But overall, it looks pretty good compared to other days that we are going to experience this week. Still super intense out there, though. The moon does align with that sextile to Neptune on Wednesday night. So again, taking pleasure in the five senses, and now we have a opportunity to take pleasure in everything Neptunian from Pisces. So this is where a Neptune aspect can be a little more positive than in other circumstances. The moon sextile Neptune, it's like, you know, taking pleasure in things that go beyond the five senses, tapping into spirituality, music, art, creativity, movies, books, you know, this nice little outlet to tap into other realities where it doesn't affect things in a negative way. It's more of a positive situation. So that's a nice little aspect we have going on there on Wednesday night. And those are the three main aspects. And right after that aspect from Moon to Neptune, then Mercury stations officially retrograde on late Wednesday night. So Mercury retrograde for the next 3 weeks, but it's already been in its shadow. And then even after it stations direct in 3 weeks, it still has to move through the rest of its shadow. So basically, there's a process going on here that involves both Venus and Mercury, and there's a lot of things that we're not quite clear about. This Venus retrograde is helping us gain clarity about our values, what we desire, what we want, possible opportunities that we want to advance on this summer, but we're not quite clear about those things until Venus is done with this. And then Mercury rules all this Gemini where that is happening. So now, this Mercury retrograde has a connection to this Venus retrograde and the Sun in Gemini and the North Node in Gemini as well. So really, it's not until late July and the first week of August that both Mercury and Venus are done with this process of evaluation and rethinking or relooking at things, or just going through a process of evaluation or waiting on something to unfold or waiting on more information and clarity before you can really be positive about making big decisions and what you'll be doing later on this year. So with Mercury retrograde stationing here, there's more emphasis on communications. There's more emphasis on the mind and the thinking process. But with Mercury in Cancer, it's wrapped up with the emotional energy. So the emotional energy and the thinking process around emotions and feelings are going to become extra strong this week, not only from Mercury stationing retrograde, but because we're building towards a solar eclipse in Cancer as well. But if you don't have to sign contracts or make big commitments or make a big decision on something with this Mercury retrograde phase, then don't do it. Now, that's the ideal situation. But life doesn't always work that way. Sometimes we have to make decisions. Sometimes we have to go forward with something, even if Mercury is retrograde. So don't get carried away with this Mercury retrograde. It's not hell. It's really not as bad as mainstream astrology makes it out to be. The way I see Mercury retrograde, it's a process. We don't have all the information that we need in order to make the best decisions. So there's a process of waiting for the information and the knowledge and just our perspective of looking at things differently. We're going through this process of trying to figure some things out. Now, Mercury in Cancer has a lot to do with the homeland. Cancer rules nations and the home. So that can be both on the mundane level with countries, And it can be on a personal level with your own family life, your own domestic situation, and your own home and personal life and what you need to feel good, you know, what you need to feel safe and secure. This is the last part of a lot of this changing energy for Cancer that we've been working up this last couple of years. This is the last big eclipse in Cancer that we're moving towards. And this Mercury retrograde has a connection to that. So thinking about safety and security for the homeland and your own family and your own domestic issues is a big part of that. So with that said, as we move into June 18, the moon is at the last few degrees of Taurus, still very exalted and still looking decent with circumstances and the mood, as the moon aligns very nicely with Pluto and Jupiter Thursday morning. And it also aligns nicely with Mars. So again, there's a continuation of some positive aspects here into Thursday morning, June 18th, where Moon trine Pluto is just an easier energy or an easier flow of circumstances and feelings working with the power and the control dynamic out in the world or in your personal life. There's an easier transformation process that's unfolding, generally speaking. There's a change, there's intensity, there's power, but we're working with it at its best in this position. And it's not forced upon us. It's not as abrasive or shadowy or as dark, but there's still intensity and there's still transformation happening. And then the moon aligning with Jupiter adds a level of optimism and hope. And there's also things that are changing here. There's laws, there's rules and regulations that are changing, based on everything that's been playing out in the world. And that change is just flowing very nicely. There's cooperation in these changes. There's a little more cooperation in general with the power and the control dynamic of authority figures, both your authority figures in the world and in your personal life, who has the power in your personal life. There's just a better flowing energy with those people. And then with the moon sextile Mars, really early on Thursday morning, it gives a great little opportunity to take appropriate action, to be more inspired to take action in some way, to do something that has a long-lasting effect that feels optimistic and hopeful, as the moon is in positive alignment with the Capricorn side and the Pisces side of everything. But there's still things that are coming up with Mercury stationing and stopped here, preparing for retrograde, that we still have to go back and look at things. All the things that are coming up in the media, conversations that you're having on a personal level, these things that are coming up the next couple of days, you know, use that to evaluate something, but don't be certain about those things because there's something that's going to be changing. So if there's something that kind of comes up tomorrow and Thursday, you may have to go back over that for the next few weeks before it's more certain, or you have it completely figured it out in some way where you can progress it forward. But there's still ideas. There's strong communication and strong ideas being spoken here this next few days about possible changes in regards to homeland security, safety, comfort, domestic issues, all these types of things. One quick second. Thursday, definitely a lot of lunar aspects. So as we go through the day, the moon will leave Taurus Thursday afternoon, Thursday evening, and ingress Gemini. So a change of mood for the second part of Thursday, June 18th. And now there's even more emphasis on Mercury stationing retrograde because the moon in Gemini is ruled by Mercury. So now there's this need for information and communication, but this is the dark moon phase now. So there's no light on the moon. It's about closing things out. It's about going within, preparing for a new beginning with the solar eclipse. But there's also this emotional need to communicate and to network and just to receive information here. The moon in Gemini wants to kind of get more lighthearted. There's this emotional need to be more lighthearted, more playful, more curious. But just the fact that we're a couple days away from a solar eclipse in Cancer, very emotional, and this is a dark moon phase, and there's just a lot of intensity out there, it's not as lighthearted as other Gemini moons would be. Now, the moon is applying a conjunction towards Venus, so there's also this emotional need for communicating in relationships and social energy. But there's still a lot of like behind the scenes activity because it's the dark moon phase before the new beginning. At the same time, as we get into later on Thursday evening, Thursday night, that's when Mars is exactly sextile Pluto. So there's a lot of power available out there in the world by Thursday. Exact on Thursday. It's already here right now. It's building up. It's exact on Thursday, and then it's going to take a few days to wane. So a lot of intensity, a lot of power, but typically the sextile is more of a positive energy, a positive aspect where we can work with the power dynamic better, less, you know, I don't want to say that there's not going to be anything crazy going on out there, because there's still a collective energy with Mars and Pisces separating from Neptune. There's still this collectiveness going on, collective action, collective moods and feelings. And when it aligns with Pluto, the power dynamic out in the world, there could still be some level of intensity. But I think generally speaking, most people are working with this in a more positive way. So again, the beginning of a process of a transformation to how we take action. Mars is going to be leaving Pisces and ingressing into Aries next week, and that's going to be a completely new Martian energy and how we take action, how we move forward, the warrior energy. So there's things that are changing here after everything that's been happening this last month with the lunar cycle in Gemini square Mars. That tension and that conflict on that level, as far as the streets and the group mind and the group thinking and what we've been seeing, it's starting to come to an end on one level. Now it's going to shift into something else, and there's still going to be a lot of intensity building up, major intensity, you know, when Mars is in Aries, but things are starting to change and transform from this point on. There's, you know, governments are changing things, and Mars rules police and military, so there's a transformation to those types of things as well. The whole thing about law enforcement reform, these are things that are really coming up in the collective and being communicated with all this type of energy. So there's determination, there's resourcefulness, there's a feeling of more power available for people to do things when Mars is sextile Pluto exact on Thursday night. And as the moon ingresses into Gemini, it forms a nice trine to Saturn. There's a feeling of stability or cooperation with authorities and the government on Thursday. And also just thinking differently. You know, now we have all this air energy, both emotionally and a lot of Gemini here, and is connecting with Saturn and Aquarius. So looking at social issues differently, thinking about these things, preparing for a new beginning, preparing for the changes in these types of situations with groups, community, social energy, ideas about the future, alternative possibilities, coming up with new plans, new ideas. And these new ideas, they're not certain yet because of all this Gemini is ruled by Mercury stationing retrograde. So it's not until Mercury goes back and forth all through June, the rest of June and all through July, until we figure it all out and we can actually move forward in a better, more, you know, more of a logical way. And the ideas are out there, but we still have to think about it and process them and go kind of back and forth over different ideas until we're certain about them. And you can apply that to your own personal situation as well. You know, it's best to wait until the end of July, first week of August, to really make big decisions or anything of value, financial things, or, you know, just your life path. we're building up to that, to those things. I mean, even all the activity that plays out the rest of June and July is important for us to figure those things out. And there could be things that are outside of our control because this is eclipse season, things that will just happen that put us on the path that we're meant to be on. But overall, if you have control over decisions, you know, I would wait until the end of July and August before doing that. Now, if you have to do something, if you have to make a decision, sign a contract, buy something, get something rolling, then that's what you have to do. But just be prepared that there's going to be setbacks. You might have to go back and do things back and forth, and it's going to be a process for you to complete it, you know, regardless. So now, as we get into Friday, June 19th, first thing in the morning, really early, the moon is conjunct Venus. So this is pretty sweet energy as far as sweet communication, this emotional need for other people to network, to be in the know, to, you know, communicate ideas and possibilities. But it's still the dark moon. So this means we're still releasing energy. We're releasing things that are connected to both relationships and material things of Taurus, as Venus is almost done with this backwards motion, and it's going to station direct next week. So the moon moving over Venus is a big part of that, where emotionally we're getting in touch with a lot of the things that we've been processing, whether consciously or unconsciously, with Venus retrograde, both financial resources, our values, relationships, possibilities with people, possibilities about the future, and all that type of stuff. One second here. All right, so Friday, moon conjunct Venus and sun conjunct the north node is a major aspect by Friday night. The moon is kind of in the in-between most of the day. It's still there with Venus, so it's kind of sweet energy most of the day, even if it's behind the scenes or private, or, you know, there's going to be this emotional need to communicate with people, your relationships. You know, either emails, networking, texting, phone calls, whatever. Most of Friday has this emotional need to communicate with people and receive information or disseminate information, something like that. And then the sun reaches the north node of destiny by Friday night. And this is a very, the sun is aligning with our destiny, the north node of destiny, and we're like super close to this eclipse. So the sun is focused on our future, but this is karmic, where life is pushing us into the direction that we're meant to be going. Believe it or not, we're not in control of every single thing. There's things that we're connected to that's beyond ourselves, that's bigger than the self. And when the north node is conjunct the sun like this, those things are being activated. We're on the path, and there's karmic situations that could play out, important information, communication, ideas, receiving some sort of information that's important. And yet, the fact that Mercury rules all this Gemini and is retrograde, we're going to have to take the next 3 weeks to process some of the information that's coming out by Friday. And that's the main two aspects on Friday. And then as we get into Saturday, June 20th, it's right before the eclipse. The sun is still conjunct the north node even on Saturday. So very karmic, fateful type of circumstances and focus and information Friday and Saturday. Now, the moon on Saturday, really early on the morning, has to square Neptune. So there's a little bit of emotional confusion first thing in the morning on Saturday, June 20th. A little bit of some of the information is scattered. It's hard to know what's real, what's not real. The moon is kind of picking up on this Gemini square Neptune aspect that we've been dealing with this last few weeks. So there's another kind of activation of that confusion, some illusions, some false narratives, or just collective information, or getting wrapped up in the collective feelings. Again, it's easier to absorb energy that's all around you, and the information is just hard to know the truth, if it's true or if it's not true. It's just hard to know. There's distractions. There may be just something that's making us question something on Saturday morning. Now, this is just for a few hours, and really the moon is at its darkest point, so it's closing out. It's also about releasing, trying to get past some of the illusions or the blind spots or the uncertainty that we've been dealing with the last few weeks. Also, on the mundane level, trying to get past these situations out in the world, trying to close them out, trying to move forward. But it's still kind of, I don't know, it's kind of just confusing and unclear and kind of messy. Some people might want to retreat. Some people might feel extra tired on Saturday morning for a few hours there. The sun is at the last degree, indicating that there's an ending Friday and Saturday. Things are about to end and close out, you know, with what we've been dealing with. There's going to be this huge change of focus. So Friday into Saturday is a major turning point. But Saturday looks a little rough around the edges because it starts with that confusion on Saturday morning. There's a lot of aspects here on Saturday. And so one other one that I didn't mention is Mars is in a sextile with Jupiter, which is helpful. Taking inspired action, taking action based on beliefs, or taking action that feels justified in some way, regardless if it is or not. But there's still right after that a lot of emotional confusion about certain situations, and the mood is getting kind of agitated here as we're so close to this eclipse and things are starting to change. And as we go through the day, the moon has to square Mars, and this is another amplification of some dark energy. The moon is at its darkest point here, square Mars, taking action, reacting to certain situations, kind of being combative and emotionally riled up or emotionally frustrated, or this need to take action and do something that isn't smooth, you know, in some way there. And right as the moon is square Mars is when the sun ingresses into Cancer, and this is the official solstice point on Saturday evening, Saturday night, depending on where you live. So the solstice, the sun has reached its highest point in the sky. And from this point on, the sun will be going down lower and lower every month. So it's a change of season, a change of focus. Now the sun is focused on really powerful emotional energy that's getting really amplified here because of the North Node and the eclipse that is going to be on the way here. So the energy is really intense again on Saturday, especially Saturday night. So now this puts focus on domestic issues even more. We've already had a little bit of that with Mercury stopped going retrograde in Cancer. But now we're really focused on these domestic issues, on issues of safety, security, your home, your family issues, and then on the mundane level, countries, borders, being, you know, how can we add a sense of feeling more secure? So security is a major focus, a major part of this solar eclipse that's building up. And so there's a big change of the overall energy by Saturday night. And it doesn't look like it feels very easy or comfortable with the moon square Mars like that. And the moon at the same time is making this in conjunction to Jupiter. So things that are going on out in the world that are justified emotionally, it feels really intense and not easy. We have to make adjustments based on new rules, new regulations, changes. And at the same time, the sun at 0 degrees is also in conjunct, also known as the quincunx, to Saturn. So there's a hard aspect here to Saturn, and that's going to be connected to new laws, regulations, authorities, everything that Saturn represents. But I'm going to talk more about that for the eclipse, because it's also strongly connected to the eclipse coming up. The moon is at the last few degrees of Gemini on Saturday night. And the moon reaches the north node as well. And it also ingresses into Cancer first thing in the morning. Let me pull up my list here, because the solar eclipse on the west coast is happening at 11:41 p.m. right before midnight. So everywhere, like, you know, the east, everywhere past Pacific time and Europe and all that, it's going to be the following day on Sunday, June 21st. So the eclipse is pretty much happening, you know, at that midnight hour on the west coast. And again, now this is really intense energy. Let me pull up the chart for that. Actually, let me show you the map of this solar eclipse first, of where it's located in the world. So the red line is where the solar eclipse is exact, and this is a really strong eclipse because it's so close to the north node. Also, the north node already went through 0 degrees of Cancer, which means this is going to be kind of an immediate, intense energy, immediate changes, whereas sometimes the eclipse energy takes time to unfold and manifest. We're still going to be looking at the next 6 months of changes to countries, homeland, family issues, domestic issues, security issues, new laws and new situations that will be changing things for people. But I think we're immediately starting to see these changes because the North Node already went through Cancer. But here's the area of the world. That red line is where it's exact. So basically through China, the Middle East, and into Africa. And then these other black lines is where it's partially visible. So we're not going to see it here in the Western Hemisphere. It's mainly through this China region again. And it's through Pakistan. So this issue with China and Pakistan, it doesn't look like it's going to go away, because this eclipse is connected to both of those countries. So you're going to see a lot of intensity in this area of the world, some new events that take place, some new security issues, and some really powerful changes for nations and borders and security issues, especially through these regions. But that doesn't mean that we all don't have this too. I mean, just because it's in the Eastern Hemisphere doesn't mean that the whole world isn't going to experience this on some level. It all depends on charts. You know, how close does this align with your personal chart and your personal planets? But it's definitely focused over there in this part of the country. Let me pull up that chart. Solar eclipse is exact, 11:41 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on June 20th. So everybody wakes up on basically Sunday morning with this eclipse energy, and it really amplifies emotions, feelings. You know, this is really watery, sensitive energy here. But Cancer is also very protective. So this is going to amplify the need to be protective of your loved ones, of what's yours, your nation, you know, and Cancer has that shell, that protective shell over it. It's going to be a strong need to go inward, to care, to be, you know, very observant of the people you care about and your family issues, domestic issues. And again, this solar eclipse has a lot to do with the world and countries. Now, this is activating the world point. The 0 degree Aries point is the world point. And because this is a cardinal energy at 0 degrees, it's square that world point. So this has, you know, world issues that are coming up around safety and security. Also, a main aspect of this eclipse is the quincunx to Saturn. So this is where nations are adjusting to new laws, new regulations. Government and authority are making changes to countries that people have to adjust to. And again, these things could start becoming quickly happening, immediately happening. But also over the next 6 months, we're going to see the results of all this shakeup. So eclipses are wild card energy. You just never know what's going to happen with this type of stuff. Emotions are so high here that people can react easily. you know, the thinking process is wrapped in to the emotional energy of everything around safety, security, home, domestic issues, borders, all those types of things. Also, this eclipse is still square Mars. You know, it's a separating aspect. It's not exact, but it's still there within orb. So there's still a lot of tension out in the world. And this is where people are these are where the changes are happening based on everything that's been playing out this last, you know, month and even this whole year. And really, it goes way beyond this. But everything that we've been dealing with leads to these changes and a new focus, a new season, a new energy that's much more emotional and watery and protective and intense with emotions and feelings and all that type of stuff. But destiny is being activated. Because this is a north node solar eclipse, this is about big changes that happen over the next 6 months that put us forward on a new path. So this is where you have to look at your chart and kind of know your chart to know how this is going to align for you. Wherever you have Cancer in your natal chart, that's where there's something that's needing to change. You know, an eclipse creates changes that are very long-lasting, very karmic. So it's like a new beginning energy, like a new moon, but it's a new moon that's amplified, that's more powerful than normal, that has longer lasting effects than normal. So wherever you have Cancer, there's this fresh new energy. Something needs to be eclipsed out of that area. Something has to change. There's shadow around that area of your life being exposed. And generally, this is exposing the shadow of emotions and feelings and domestic issues and safety, security issues and homeland border issues and all those types of things. The dark side is being exposed with this eclipse. And it kind of like shakes us up. It shakes us out of something. It changes our perspective because Mercury is also right there. And that's where we have to start looking at things differently and go through this evaluation process with Mercury retrograde at the same time. So Saturn in Aquarius, this is like the last big aspect, I think, before Saturn moves back into Capricorn and finalizes that Capricorn-Saturn-Pluto aspect Jupiter situation there. So we've been getting a glimpse of this Saturn in Aquarius, these boundaries that are coming up in social situations. And I think that there's going to be some new stuff that's forced upon us that we have to adjust to that doesn't feel exactly easy. This is kind of an aspect of irritation. The adjustments that we have to make based on the government and the authorities and the rules and the changing of situations don't feel easy. It's agitating, it's irritating, but we have no choice but to deal with it. And Saturn is asking for what, you know, structure in the society, group activity, is laws, like the way that the world is opening up again after this virus situation, which, by the way, I think that most people should be prepared for government to start making more BS, you know, rules and laws and taking more power, especially when Saturn comes back into Capricorn and now Jupiter is moving back towards Pluto. So Pluto is the power and the control dynamic within governments, governments of all kinds, federal, state, all the way down to the local governments. They have a shadow aspect to them. They're taking more power, more control than normal. And because Jupiter is there, it's justified. And then also Jupiter is amplifying everything that Pluto represents, the shadow, the transformation, the deeper, darker things about society and the institutions and just the way that we live. Jupiter is just blowing all that out of proportion, and it's going to amplify the changes and the transformation and the government power and control. So the fact that Jupiter is going to be headed back to Pluto, which isn't exact this week, but just to prepare you, you know, that they are going to make more laws that are justified, take more power that's justified. Basically all of 2020, three separate phases of that process. And this virus, it could be, whether it doesn't matter your beliefs about the virus, that's not my point here. It's about the what I see in the astrology is that regardless of the details of it all, it's going to be coming back, more amplification, and then we're going to experience some new situations that are very, very intense with Mars ingressing into Aries, going retrograde for the rest of the year. This could be I talked about this many times in the past. This could be military conflicts that are going to be building up, because this eclipse is setting off that Aries point around borders and nations and countries that want more security. So Mars is going to come into that and start to fight for something. And I mean, this is just a super intense year, obviously. We've already been experiencing things, but there's going to be more and more situations out there in 2020. You know, this is just a crazy time that we're living in. So boundaries are still super needed. I mean, with all this Piscean energy, it's now that the squares are moving away from this Pisces Neptune stuff. The vibe that we've been in the past few weeks is going to be changing for sure. And in fact, this Cancer season will be more in harmony with Neptune and Pisces. We can work with Neptune, dreams, imagination, inspiration, you know, wanting to change things and for the better. We can work with that in a little bit of a better way, where it's more smooth and more logical and realistic as we advance through Cancer season, because it's no longer going to be a square to Neptune. So, you know, I just say things the way I see them. When there's hard aspects to Neptune is when Neptune is not at its best use. Now, when there's positive alignments to Neptune, we can work with it better. So, I mean, there's a time, there's a season for positive Neptune, and there's a season for negative Neptune things. But Neptune in Pisces is so different from any other Neptune placement. And it's not about Pisces, it's about Neptune in Pisces. Just want to clarify that, because some people get all riled up when I talk about negatives with Neptune. So anyway, Mars is, you know, moving through the last degrees of Pisces, which is kind of the challenging position. And Mars is going to be moving into T-square, the nodes of fate, but that's not going to be this week. So, but it is building up to where we're at, this major turning point in a lot of different ways. So, you know, just find your Cancerian area of life in your birth chart, and that's where there's a new focus. That's where there's big karmic changes. And we've had eclipses in this area already the last, you know, year or so. And this is the big final one. This is where I've been telling people for the last couple years, you know, get in touch with what you need to feel safe and secure. Get in touch with where you want to live, where you want to be for the long term. You know, your safety, your security, your comfort. Find out what you need, you know, in those regards this last 2 years. And this is like the last big change that we have an opportunity to make before, at least, you know, we can always make those changes, don't get me wrong. But what I'm trying to say is, like, when there's energy there, when there's transits there, and especially when the North Node was moving through there, it gave us an opportunity to do those things easier than otherwise, you know. So you can do those things later on, but they're not going to be as supported. It won't be as easy. Or you might not have the options that you've had the last couple years to make these powerful changes to your home life, your family dynamics, your domestic issues, you know, and just being in a place that feels safe and secure no matter what is going on in the outer world with all this heavy Pluto, Saturn stuff. And, you know, this is the season that we have an opportunity to finalize those changes and really get in touch with where we want to be. And this Mercury retrograde through Cancer is what's going to help us really come to that conclusion, finally, to finalize that conclusion. And maybe you've already started that process. Most people have, because of these eclipses that we've already had in Cancer. But this is the last bit of that, where the last easy opportunity to figure all this family, home, living, property, land, real estate, you know, emotions, feelings, what you need to feel good and what you need to nurture yourself, you know, all these things on a personal level, what you personally need, what your loved ones need. This is a big time to really be focused on all those types of things. But it's exposing the dark side of it all too. So you're going to see a lot of family issues starting to build up now. So you're going to see it on the mundane level with nations kind of getting all riled up and wanting to be protective of their homeland. And now you're going to see it, too, on personal levels with your own family, your own neighborhood, your own environment where you live. issues are going to be coming up. And you need good boundaries. You need good structure. And, you know, all these things that I've been talking about through the last several reports, this is a major new beginning in a lot of those ways. And wherever you have that area in your chart, powerful new beginning there. So that's pretty much what I can say. I mean, I could probably go on and say a lot more, but let's continue on with this report before these storms hit. So all day on Sunday, the moon is moving through this emotional energy, much more sensitive, much more protective, focused on being in a place that feels safe and comfortable, you know, dealing with these domestic issues and everything that I was just saying right there. So really only one aspect on June 21st, Sunday, and that is the moon sextile Uranus, which will happen later on in the day, about the evening, Sunday evening, June 21st, moon sextile Uranus. And this is where we have an opportunity to apply this Uranus in Taurus transit to our domestic home, family, feelings, what we need, safety, security. Look at things differently. Look at things outside of the box. Be inventive. Be willing to try new things in regards to your family, to your finances, your money, your resources, in regards to your home and family and domestic life, your safety, your security, all those types of things. An opportunity to apply some sort of innovative situation. And at least there's an opportunity for that. Not everybody will do that. There's just an opportunity. It's not forced, you know, it's just an opportunity. So the moon is pretty much in that solar eclipse energy all day on Sunday. It's just super intense emotional energy. And then by Monday, June 22nd, the moon is conjunct Mercury retrograde. So this strong emotional energy for information, communication, connected to the Cancerian things of home and family, domestic, safety, security, comfort, all those things I was talking about. I should also say that this eclipse is strongly connected to the United States. In fact, all three eclipses are connected to the United States. This is powerful changes for the United States that have a long-lasting effect. So although there's been a lot of, you know, illusions and confusion, and not everything has been realistic with ideas and possibilities that you've heard about, not everything communicated, you know, is 100% realistic or down to earth. Not every narrative out there that's been out there the last month is 100% truth. There's been this collective energy, like I've been talking about the last few weeks. But regardless of that, because of these eclipses, it still creates long-lasting changes for good or bad. You know, like I just saw the other a clip that the John Sutter statue in Sacramento was taken down because I guess he used Native Americans to build it. So, you know, taking down these statues all across the country is so symbolic of this Capricorn transit, of what's happening with this restructuring to this country and to other countries. It's everything playing out there in the world is shown in the astrology. But there's definitely really powerful changes for the United States and other countries with these eclipses, especially the United States. This is also going to change some financial issues. Cancer rules the eighth house for the United States. And the next eclipse in Capricorn, talk about that in another time, but that's going to be in the financial house of the United States. So big financial changes. I've talked about this for a while already. New currencies, just a change of how we trade, change of values. All these things are really powerful for the United States. But yeah, strong emotional energy to communicate about feelings and sensitive issues on Monday, really early in the morning there. the moon isn't conjunct Uranus on Monday. I don't know why I have that. Sextile Uranus, I guess I meant. Moon sextile Uranus. I'm not sure about that aspect. I have to change that one. Moon trine Neptune. Moon not Pluto. Okay, so let's move this forward. And by the time we get to Monday afternoon, the moon is aligned nicely with Neptune. So this is a little more of a positive activation of Neptune. Neptune is super strong. You can already see that S showing up. It doesn't officially station until later on Monday night, but all, you know, it's already not moving. Neptune takes a long time. It's lost all of its momentum. It's extra powerful. There's more emphasis on it. And that's that collectiveness I've been talking about. You know, a lot of dreams and inspiration and a lot of fantasies, but there's also illusions and delusions and all kinds of BS connected to it as well. But on this particular alignment on Monday afternoon, we're nurturing ourselves through Neptunian things. There's an easy open outlet to find nurturing through spirituality, metaphysics, compassion, humanitarian things, music, art, you know, all those Neptunian things, your own little world. The moon is in the home and family area, so your protective area, the area that you feel safe and secure and kind of retreat, the possibility of retreating, you know, at least a few hours there. A lot of water energy, wanting to be nurtured through water. It could be literally, you know, or those types of things. And then the emotional energy, you know, no matter what, though, even with that open outlet to retreat or escape into something that's more pleasant from behind the scenes, it's still the eclipse energy. You know, it's still a very, very powerful emotional energy that's all riled up. And that increases later on Monday night when the moon is opposing Pluto. So there's this opposition to the safety and the security. There's this power and control, this dark side that we're emotionally picking up on, generally speaking here, that doesn't feel safe, it doesn't feel comfortable, it doesn't feel easy. Trying to push away the darkness, trying to push away the shadow that could be both out in the world with the public, or it could be manifesting within your home and family dynamics, within your own environment too. It all depends, but it's intense. And we're kind of going through this emotional transformation phase that feels a little bit intense there. And the moon is opposite Jupiter. So Jupiter's back in the 24th degree. There's Pluto. So again, this amping up of Jupiter-Pluto is coming back, which will be, if you think about it, you have to think about the first pass. The first pass was the peak of the virus, the power, the control, the laws that were justified, the martial law type of energy that was all justified and amplified. There's likely going to be a return to that. On some level, governments are going to start taking more power again, doing more things that people don't like, that people don't want. And it feels like the circumstances are connecting to all that on a Monday night, but it's only going to increase from this point on. The moon does align with Mars, so good emotional energy. It's intense, it's riled up, but we're working with the action a little better, but this is like super late, first thing in the morning on Tuesday, June 23. So a lot of people are sleeping, but there could be a lot of activity, you know, through the midnight hour of Monday into Tuesday. Strong emotional need to take action. Yeah, so before we start on Tuesday here, Neptune is stationing RX exactly at 9:32 p.m. Pacific time. So again, like early morning hours on Tuesday morning for the rest of the country. So Neptune is extra powerful, extra strong, illusions, delusions, fantasies, hopes, dreams, all these things are super strong. And Mars is still kind of there. We're still the collectiveness of it all is, you know, people are picking up on the world collective inspiration and dreams and hopes and all these types of things. Now, does that mean it's all realistic? Does that mean it's all going to happen? Is it all grounded? No. Now, some things are, don't get me wrong. Some things are possible. Some things will, you know, are realistic. But, you know, are you going to be like getting rid of police departments completely, stuff like that? That's probably not going to happen. That's more of the dream, the illusion, the fantasy that's been activated. Now, is there going to be reform and changes? 100%, yes. So it's a combination of both BS and some dreams, possibilities, hope, inspiration, and all that. It's extra powerful. And as Neptune now stations retrograde for the rest of the year, well, it's not stationed retrograde for the rest of the year. It'll be moving retrograde for the rest of the year. This will give humanity time to evaluate these dreams and these possibilities to figure out if things are BS, an illusion, or if they're possible. And that's what we'll be doing for the rest of the year. So all day on Tuesday, well, no, the first part of Tuesday, the early morning hours of Tuesday, the moon is at the last degrees of Cancer. And then the moon will ingress into Leo the second part of the day. Actually, it's 6 a.m. West Coast time, so still morning on the East Coast. So really, there's a big change of energy on Tuesday with the moon in Leo. And it's as soon as it ingresses Leo, it's opposite Saturn. So there's a change of mood, a change of circumstances, and it's coming out more fiery. The moon is building, it's waxing. Now the moon wants to express, so people want to express their feelings and more passionately in Leo. There's a need for fun and joy. But right when that shift is happening and it's opposing Saturn, it feels heavy, it feels restrictive and limited on being able to find the joy or the happiness as easily as we might in other circumstances. So there could be this need to just do something different, to move out of what's been happening the last few days with that eclipse, and just the mood changes drastically. But it feels like there's going to be some crazy energy. We're still in that eclipse vibe, and the moon is applying a square to Uranus. That's pretty much the last aspect of the day, is that square to Uranus, which can add some drama, some disruptions, some clashes, some stubbornness, fixed energy, the need for fun, joy, passion, having a good time. But there's also things that are disruptive, and there's some instability going on, perhaps Tuesday, especially late Tuesday night. But even this moon transit through Leo leads back to the sun in Cancer. So this drama and this activation of more passion and expressing self still leads back to the safety, security, the nation, the homeland, family, domestic concerns and focus. All right, so that's what I have for you. Hopefully that made sense and you were able to follow along. I appreciate you watching, and I wish you all the best and happy solar eclipse. Catch you on the next one.